This date on 2013, Arthur bullied Sue Ellen because of her new sweater, then gaslit her in an apology letter. Okay. She has an ugly sweater. He makes fun of her sweater. She cries. Dear Sue Ellen, I'm sorry to upset you. I didn't mean to. It was really just a joke. I thought you could take a joke, but I guess I was wrong. A terrible apology. Did he get in trouble for this? Is that the definition of gaslighting? I thought you could take a joke. I thought we were friends. Oh, is this the episode? I can just watch it? It's public access. This should be allowed, right? Why wouldn't this be allowed on Twitch? Shut up, shut up, shut up, shut up, shut your mouth. This is commentary? This is commentary or something. All right, copy, no copy, no copy scronking, no copy scronking.
I put it on right away. It was a little big, but I didn't care. It was instantly my favorite sweater.
What is this animation? It's
sweater,
public access television animation. Give it a break. Something about the line work is interesting, where they kind of just randomly take lines out, little dashes out.
So funny, I forgot to laugh.
All right, let's hear the joke, first of all. I want to hear the joke in question.
Come here, girl. Over here.
Oh, like he's a like she's a dog?
Who's a good sheep doggy? You're a good sheep doggy. Yes, you are.
Okay, you can stop now.
Okay, wait, first of all. Dogs are people in this show. Dogs are people. Calling someone a dog is not an insult. That's like calling someone Asian. It would be super weird to do, but it's not like inherently like, it's not instantly like, it's more like, whoa, what are we doing here? It's definitely not.
Oh yes, I love one of the big boys.
It's definitely not, but it's not, wait, I don't know. Shut up, Ty, keep working. So the joke is that she looks like a dog, even though she has cat ears and is a cat. Let's keep moving.
Here, why don't you have my biscuit?
Arthur, that's a bad joke. Arthur, that's people food. You're offering her people food because you think she's a dog? She looks like a dog? Arthur, that's people food. Wait, serious question. Is Steven Crowder in this episode? Is the brain played by Steven Crowder in this show in 2013 or not? Because I see the brain right here, and the brain was played by Steven Crowder. So that's also very important to me to know. 2013's too late. Okay.
Dog Appreciation Day?
You went too far, buddy. He went too far. He went too far! You've gone too far.
Did you do this?
Yes, he did that.
Well, it was just a joke.
Well, I don't think it's funny.
Dirtbag leftist. Dirtbag leftist Arthur makes fun of lady in her ugly sweater. So, let me see the image again. He didn't even get the color of the sweater right. I mean, I guess it's in crayons or whatever middle schoolers do. How old is Arthur? How long's he been in fourth grade?
Happy sheepdog.
Like, he didn't put the pattern on it or anything. I don't know.
Appreciation Day?
It's just a joke.
That doesn't look a thing like Sue Ellen. Or
it doesn't.
A dog.
It doesn't.
Give it a tail.
It's so true, man. Even the bully is like, dude, you suck.
Arthur, would you stay behind, please?
She didn't have to go to Mr. Ratburn. She could have just told me to stop.
She did.
She
tell
did
you
tell
to
you
stop.
To stop.
I was there.
She was being oversensitive, right?
No, you suck, dude.
Saying you're sorry isn't that hard. You'll be finished with that letter in no time.
Writing a letter in fourth grade was hard,
Dear
man.
Sue Ellen,
that was like brutal.
Sorry I upset you. I didn't mean to. It was really just a joke. I've been teased before about wearing glasses.
But I never felt I had to tell the teacher about it and get someone else in trouble. Maybe you're just overreacting?
It goes on like that for the whole page.
He sucks.
Isn't sorry at all. Until
all right, what are they going to do about
apology?
It? When does he actually
I'm
start feeling bad?
To him. Me too.
Bro, they're canceling him. We are not talking to Arthur anymore. He's canceled.
How about that history test? Pretty hard, right?
This is cancel culture.
What's going on?
Steven Crowder experienced it, and now Arthur is experiencing it.
That's what's going on.
Why aren't you speaking to me?
I tell you, suck. But I'm not speaking.
You just did it again! Oh, come on, Francine. Let's sit at a table that doesn't have any bullies at it.
I'm not a bully. What did I do wrong?
Buster learned. You don't talk to me.
Your letter to Sue Ellen. What about it?
It was terrible. Bad. That's why I'm not speaking to you.
What do you mean my letter was bad? I'm just a little sociopath.
Sue Ellen, wait up. Can we please just forget it and be friends?
See, now the problem is he doesn't feel bad. He doesn't feel remorse. He doesn't like the consequences for his action. Has he really learned anything? The man is still a bad person. He simply doesn't like that people aren't talking to him now. Go ahead, Arthur. Learn your lesson.
Do you still think I overreacted?
Well...
Oh, now he's doubling down. He's going into Photoshop. Whoa. Arthur, he's reached troll territory. Arthur, what are you thinking? Why do you think that would help? What is going on in this show? He's cyberbullying now with Photoshop. It's like if I did this to somebody. You got dog head, brother. Why? Wait. Back. I need to read her email. Pause it. She's writing an essay about cancer research. Terry Fox was 22 years when he dipped his artificial leg in the ocean of St. John's, Newfoundland. His goal was to run across Canada in hopes of raising $25 million for cancer research. Sorry, Sue Ellen, it looks like you put two spaces between 25 million and four. Probably got to get rid of that extra space there. People thought he was foolish for trying to run so far on one leg. At first, he didn't get attention, but as weeks passed, he became a household name. He ran far each day in difficult conditions like snow and rain. After a few months, even the mayor and television crews came out to meet Terry. In August, Sue Ellen, you're going to need a comma after August. These are small. I'm being very nitpicky here, but you will need a comma after that. Yeah, the font's a little bit condensed. Could I suggest some better typeface choices? A serif font will be more legible. Probably something like, I mean, it's very cliche, but Times New Roman. Yeah, just a simple 10-point Times New Roman or Minion's very good. If you're dead set on using a sans serif font, you could do Calibri. That's what Apple uses. Anyways, after a few months, even the mayors and television crews came out to meet Terry. In August, over halfway through his journey, halfway I think is one word, not two. It looks like you have a space there. He had to return to the hospital. He had cancer again. He vowed to, looks like there's two spaces there, continue his run, but on, he died. Terry Fox died, I'm sure. She's giving it away. Dude, he's eating with the bullies now, dude. Dude, she's leaving school. She's transferring. Because of Arthur cyberbullying him.
She can't be changing classes because of me.
Yeah, she can. You're mean to her. She donated the sweater. She hates it. Dude, you should wear the sweater now.
You left your backpack behind. Bad dog. Who's a good sheepdoggy? You're a good sheepdoggy. Yes, you are. Are you sure?
Are there dogs in this universe?
Not a dog,
like
show?
Real, like dog
it was
dogs?
Just a joke.
Well,
Binky is a
you
dog.
You didn't overreact.
Could be.
I have been a bully.
Yes, you have.
I just didn't realize how hurt you were. But now I do. Please don't switch classes. You're one of my best friends, and if you stay in our class, I promise to never treat you like that again. And I promise to wear this every day for the rest of the year. Deal?
No, I want it back.
Deal.
How
but
is that?
I think I'll take my sweater back.
It really is the warmest thing I've ever worn.
And soft, right? Although it does kind of make you look
I'll
like
I'll wear
a
this every day. Squeak, squeak. Dude, I like her. She's the coolest one in the whole And I say, hey!
Watch more, Arthur.
Well, that was fun. What a crazy world we live in, where you have to teach 10-year-olds not to cyberbully their friends.